to honor America, without which JRMC will present our nation's colors. Please rise and join us for the playing of the national anthem and remain standing for the Southeast alma mater.
The following program is produced entirely by the television production students of Southeast High School, in partnership with Kaiser University. The following program is produced entirely by the television production students of Southeast High School, in partnership with Kaiser University, and by the medical experts at Intercoastal Cardiology of Sarasota, and by the financial advisors at Mott & Associates in Bradenton.
County Cross City matchup. The first district game of the year. I'm glad to be joined in the booth tonight by Mike Federico and surrounded by the brain trust of SETV, Mike Sanders and Mike Brooks. I guess the Mike and Mike show is in here trying to work and get this thing set up. But we're glad to have you here. We've had the Mighty Mites, Mike. We've had the Mighty Mites out here.
Yeah, we had the young guys out there playing some football here for about 30 minutes and looked like they were thoroughly enjoying themselves.
Well, not only. Got a lot of people here in the stands, a lot of folks on the field. A lot of food in the booth. We want to thank Popey's Place over 6409 Manatee Avenue West for providing the meatballs and sausages and pasta, some salad. So plenty of food to be had.
Yeah, the food from Popey's Place was excellent. So we got to enjoy ourselves a little bit, and hopefully now we'll kick this off and we'll enjoy ourselves a little bit more. Well, it looks like we're kicking tonight. So let's run down and cover this kick and play some defense, and let's see what we can do tonight.
And the folks at home will be able to see us now. They'll be able to see whether we got any marinara sauce on our faces.
Or on our brand new shirts.
These are brand new. We are color coordinated with the team shirts, and there's a lot of orange here and a lot of green with the Mighty Mites. So I don't know when I've seen this many kids here. So this is a good sign. Get those young kids over here and let them see, get a taste of Friday night football, and maybe they'll want to come back here and play someday.
Well, it's a beautiful campus. It's in great shape. The field looks like it's in good shape tonight. Hopefully the rain will hold off, and we'll get to play some ball tonight.
Had some rain out east about 4 o'clock, 4:35, as I was coming back from golf practice. A good bit of rain. I thought it was going to be bad for us tonight, but apparently it was a cell that was moving south, so maybe we'll be good tonight. It's our first district game of the year.
It is, and these are the ones that count. These are the money games. You know, we need to execute. We shot ourselves in the foot a lot last week. Didn't play good coming down the stretch, and had that game there for the taking. We were inside their 20-yard line six, seven times last week and kicked a couple field goals, and that's all we got out of tonight. So tonight we need to convert.
Especially at a district game, we're not going to make headway if we're not winning. We got to score points.
Yeah, that's exactly right. We need to score points, play defense, play clean football, and win these district games, because that's where it counts.
I didn't watch the toss because I was watching the Mighty Mites and making sure I didn't have marinara sauce on my chin. But it looks like Southeast is kicking off, so maybe we won the toss and elected to receive it in the second half. That would make sense. But got it teed up right now, number 78 for the Knowles. Of course, it's not going to be on my roster that I have in front of me. You've got the official roster, don't you? Herb's got the kickoff, and the ball's going to go out of bounds over on the Bayshore side of the field. And Bayshore will take over first and 10. From somewhere around the 20, kind of waiting on them. The legal procedure against Bayshore. What happened? How do you get the legal procedure on the kickoff?
I did not pick that one up. I was paying attention to our kick. It was a little pop fly that skidded out of bounds there. And that's going to cost us some field position to start the game and put our defense in a little bit of a short field. So
now they're saying it's against Southeast. So now it makes some more sense. So we have the Bayshore on offense. Again, Bayshore so far has not scored this year. Quarterback, I believe, is number 5, Ryan O'Neill. I'm waiting to see a number. He's throwing down the field. He's got a receiver. Don't know why they haven't scored this year when they can throw a ball like that inside the 20 down to the 15-yard line. Nice pass. He was warming up and looked pretty good early on and carried it on into real action, too. That's a great play.
Totally caught us off guard there. He threw the ball on a little post, short post right there.
We got a replay here on it. Watch O'Neill. That was a nice, well, I thought it was a nice ball. It looked a lame duck there, but wounded duck. But it landed down inside the 20, 15-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for the Bruins. Quarterback in the shotgun, man in motion right to left. Fake the handoff to him. Quarterback keeper, he's going to lose 2 or 3 yards. Good defensive play there by, it looks like, number 44 for the Knowles, Zach Hughes. Zach Hughes last week had a standout game.
Yeah, and that was a beautiful tackle right there. He took a great angle of pursuit. He recognized it and wrapped him up real nice and dropped him for a yard loss.
We bring up a second down and 11. Again, the ball looks like it's just on the 16-yard line. Quarterback Neal in the shotgun. It could be number 32, Alexander, flanked to his right. We've got a flag down.
Yeah, that's on their right tackle. He flinched a little bit, and that's going to cost him 5 yards.
I think Bayshore's a lot like us. They can't afford to make these mistakes. We're talking about shooting ourselves in the foot last week. I think Bayshore's got a good target on their foot as well.
Now, football's a real simple game. You got 11 people, 11 jobs, and they all got to commit and do it.
Second down and 16. There's the fake handoff and got him under pressure. They're going to tackle him back outside the 30-yard line. They're going to mark him on the 31st. That's a huge sack. Probably another loss of 10 yards. Yeah, they're going to take it out to the 32-yard line. I got a replay here. Watch as Neal turned around. He got DQ'd by Daquan Williams at number 21 in there as well for the Noles.
Schneider Pierre.
Schneider's fast. Schneider's got a lot of speed, according to Coach Montgomery, the defensive coordinator. Got a third and 26. Noles threaten blitz. They bring it right up the middle. And the quarterback is going to get hit and brought down at the 40-yard line for another loss. Again, Snyder-Pierre in on that, as well as Daquan Williams, and trying to see who else is getting off that stack. A little slowly walking. It could be Zach Hughes has a little limp. But
yeah, I think Zach got his ankle rolled up a little bit there on the end. But Daquan Williams, if you're the offensive team, you have got to account for our number 7 on every play.
Yeah, Daquan, he's fast. He had a talk about stellar game. He and Zach Hughes both last week against Palmetto had just strong performances. So Bayshore is going to squander that great pass play under heavy rush. And he gets the kickoff. It's going to come down. Oh, my gracious. You can't do that, I don't think. Tyler Stevenson. Ready to get the kick. I don't know if you even want to see a replay on this.
Oh, he, poor kid, just got totally.
My gracious.
Totally depleted without any ability to catch the football there. Totally impeded.
I haven't seen that kind of play in a long time. Watch this. What a replay. Look at that. Here we go. And now here's Tyler ready for it. Oh, my. Somebody get the license number on that truck.
Close to catching it.
My gracious. Well, that's going to tack on some yards. So the Noles will get a better field position.
Well, we went after that kick, too, and I just don't know how we missed it. We were right there in front of it. They took good angles, so they didn't commit the roughing the kicker penalty, but we just missed blocking that punt.
The Noles are going to have it on the 24-yard line, first and 10, first opportunity on offense. Quarterback is Alex Taylor. Peavy, who had a monster game last week, 90-something yards, according to the newspaper, is the tailback. Taylor in the shotgun, man in motion, right to left. There's the pitch to the number 2. Is going to be Pryor on the jet sweep, I believe. And he's going to pick up little and like it.
Yeah, he ducked in, and it was tied up in there. He might have wanted to just slide that right on the outside and see what he could get booking to the sideline.
Yeah, little or no gain on that. It's going to bring up a second down and 10. Alex Taylor, the junior quarterback, all over his head, is going to go inside the 10-yard line, and Alex is going to fall on it back at the 3-yard line. That's one of the hardest snaps I've ever seen.
Well, we're going to make out okay. He made a smart play by falling on it, and then the Bayshore player pounced on him pretty aggressively, so got called for a personal foul here.
So we'll get 15 back after a loss of 20, I think. It was a I just looked up and saw that ball go sailing over Alex's head. I don't know if we've got a replay of that, but it was on a rail.
Well, we've seen about four or five crazy plays already in the first couple minutes of the game, so looks like Friday night.
Well, second down and 15, it looks like, based on the yardage marker, the ball's inside the 20, probably around the 18-yard line. Taylor in the shotgun, standing back on the 12-yard line. He's got the snap, looking. He throws it down the sideline. He's got a wide-open receiver. Got him at the 50-yard line, inside the 40, tackle. Oh, my, what a beautiful play. And that's going to be Pryor on the catch. Terrence Pryor, Jr., and Alex hit him on the money.
Well, that was just a fantastic pass.
But watch Alex here. He looks. He's got it. Goes down the seam. And look at Pryor. Doesn't even break a stride. And you like to see that kind of stuff. That's exciting. There's a handoff to PB up the middle, and he's going to get inside the 30, I believe, to about the 29-yard line. That'll be a pickup of 7. Good play.
Well, I like this. We're up a quick tempo here, getting right to the line of scrimmage, just snapping the ball, and Mr. Peavy gashed him really nicely there up the middle.
Got an uncovered receiver. Got uncovered receiver here in the slot now. And there's the throw, and it could be intercepted. My gracious, what a great play by the defensive back on a poor throw. Somebody was uncovered, but we didn't take advantage of it.
Yeah, Alex was on the move there, and of course his feet are moving, but he's got to settle down and make that throw and get it down in the target range instead of letting it sail like that. That was almost a easy pickoff.
Third down and 3 for the Noles. Ball inside the 30-yard line, 7:45 to go in the first quarter. And there's a handoff to Peavy, who's going to try to stretch it out. And he's going to get maybe a yard. That's going to bring up a fourth down and 1. And I wouldn't be surprised if we don't go for it. We're kind of in that tweener yardage.
No, we're definitely going to go for it. We're out of field goal range, and
yeah, Julio's been kicking, Julio Martinez, and I think they're going to feel better about going for a 4th and 2 on the backs of Alex Taylor, junior quarterback. Got the snap, he wants to pitch it. He's got it on the option, and he's going to have the first down inside the 25-yard line, and Alex took a licking and kept on ticking. That was number 5 for the Noles. Is Quan Birch on the carry. That'll move the chains for a first down, Seminoles. Again, hurry up offense. Alex Taylor in the shotgun. Birch looks to his right. Alex looking to throw. He's going to it out into just around the 20-yard line. There'll be a pickup of 1, maybe 2. That's a long throw.
That was a long throw.
Dangerous.
Yeah, across the wide side of the field, and he sailed it a little bit. That's an interesting play call.
Somebody cut that thing off, and they're still running.
Mm-hmm.
They'll be running past Samoset Elementary by now. Second down and 9. Ball just outside the 20-yard line. There's the snap. Pull it back. There's a little screen. There's the jet inside the 15, inside the 10, and it's going to be Stevens. Tyler Stevenson inside the 10 to the out the 7-yard line. First down, first and goal, Noles.
That was excellent, excellent execution.
Now watch Tyler over here in the flat. He's got it, and then he's just waiting on his blockers.
He makes that little turn to the outside there and powers over to the sideline. Almost took it to the house.
First and goal, PB. No, it's not PB up the middle, but it's going to be touchdown. Number 5 is Quan Birch on the touchdown. Well, that's a good play. He bounced off. Looked like a pinball out there, bouncing off a few people, found his way into the end zone for 6 for the Noles.
Yes, definitely. Got hit at the 3-yard line, bounced off, and then dove into the end zone. Got the ball across the goal line.
6:10 to go in the first quarter. We haven't even had a water timeout yet. The Noles are on the board. That's different than we've been seeing this year.
Going. Let's see if we can convert.
Julio Martinez in for the extra point attempt. And it's going to be up and good. Hurry up and get that signal up so we can know whether it was good or not. Now watch Quan here. Watch it bounce off. Good.
Twins. And Pip sticks the ball out, and he's in the end zone for six.
That's great balance right there. I love that drive, the up-tempo offense, no huddle, quick to the line of scrimmage, caught the defense completely off guard. We got some nice rhythm going on those plays right there. I hope that is what we're going to have the rest of the night.
Just saw Darren Grant on the sideline talking to the coach. He's wearing number 66, the offensive line. I think he's going both ways, and man, he's a good-looking kid.
Yeah, he's got some good size to him.
We've got a bunch of guys that have some. That's a decent height, not a lot of weight, not a lot of bulk, but don't grow into it.
Well, we've got some great athletes. You know, we played a very respectable football game against Palmetto last week. Like I said, we had the ball down inside their 20-yard line a bunch of times. We just did not convert. The kicking game let us down several times. Just a whole a bunch of little things that really cost us that football game. We were in it right till the end.
Kenneth has it teed up on the 40-yard line again. 6:10 to go in the first quarter. Noles leading 7-0 over the Bruins from Bayshore here at Paul Megley Field. Paul Megley Field just kind of rolls right off there. It's a pretty good low liner. He's going to come inside the 11-yard line out to the 15. 20 tries to get a lane around the side across the 30. There's a block in the back. This one's going to come back, and he's going to get hit. Don't tackle him out of bounds. We'll put flags on that. Inside the 30-yard line, there's a flag. 35-yard line, there's a flag.
That's disappointing there that we let that return get outside. Our contained man just totally left the integrity at a corner there and came down inside too quick, and their runner took advantage of it.
Block in the back. And personal foul against Southeast. So there you have it. They're going to offset. It was our personal foul. A little scrum there off the...
I didn't see it, so maybe it was on the out-of-bounds, riding him out-of-bounds into the bench. I'm not...
riding him out, but he let go of him.
I'm going to re-kick it. It's our fall season. Break down in the position in the last 5 yards and just sailed right on by. He picked up an extra 10, 12, 14 yards off of that. Our Jonathan Locke that came off the corner there, blitzed in that 3-4 formation, stand up there off the corner and made a nice tackle.
A loss of almost three, going to make it to second and 13. Be on the shotgun. Knowles threatened blitz, they bring it, and Oh, there's our train wreck at the 36-yard line, number 33 for the Noles. Will Smith Cotton on the hit. My gracious. The receiver caught the ball, turned to run upfield, and he got a face full of will.
Well, he wasn't.
A face full of what? Look at, watch this replay here. And he catches the ball, and that is a stick.
That's what you call a perfect form tackle. Perfect form tackle. Hit him right in the chest, wrap him up, and drive him into the ground.
You can hide those biceps, keep them somewhere else. Just keep making play. Got an uncovered receiver. Got the receiver stacked to the right. Stacked right, stacked left. Heavy rush. Neal evades it. Looking for... almost intercepted. I was looking to see if he was getting awfully close to the line of scrimmage.
Well, that was a great close by Brandon Shannon there, and a nice hit at the end.
Yeah, watch him. There's Amita rolling. And he throws it back. Defensive back right in front of the receiver as they will break that up.
O'Neal looks like he's got a little bit of some feet, so we got to keep him in the pocket. We can't let him get around that corner and throw the ball.
Throwing the ball well, but actually both Bayshore quarterbacks were throwing the ball well in warm-ups, but that's not having anybody in your face, and a lot of things can change. Speaking of in your face, there's a blocked punt! Noles are going to pick it up, inside the 40, down the sideline, he's going to be into the end zone, touchdown Noles! The jailbreak.
That was great.
It's at 52 for the Noles on the touchdown. Jordan Sims.
And it looked like it was our number 28, Clyde Townsend, coming off the corner to block that kick.
I wonder if we got a replay. Wouldn't that be something? We've had a lot of good replays.
That'd be a great one to have.
Martinez will be in for the extra point attempt. 4:07 to go in the first quarter. Noles have doubled their output for the season.
We've got some great young players on the team and some good athletes. We just need to keep our head in the game, everybody do their job on their play, and execute what's called.
Team's getting the ball teed up on the 40-yard line. So another kickoff. How many kickoffs we've had this year? You don't score, you don't kick off twice a game.
Yeah, we probably had three at Palmetto, right?
3366 extension 2024. Also, our kick recovery system down at the 18-yard line. Oh, face mask. I think that's a face mask. Is there any doubt that that was a face mask? Yeah, number 33 got a handful of Please see Mr. Will Smith coin. Helmet came right off, and that's going to be 15 yards against the Noles. Hey, we're proud to announce Kaiser University of Sarasota is once again a business partner of SETV. This is the 12th year that Kaiser has supported the television production program of Southeast High. At Kaiser University Sarasota campus, you can get training you need to pursue a new career in the field of business, criminal justice, education, healthcare, information technology, law, and much more. They offer associates,
bachelor's and graduate degree programs. Their Sarasota campus also offers culinary arts, baking, and pastry program. You can find out more about what Kaiser has to offer by simply going to their website at kaiseruniversity.edu.
Well, I'm not so disappointed in an aggressive penalty like that. You're running by the man. You're reaching out to grab him. You're going for the jersey, of course, the shoulder pad. Your hand gets up in the grill, and he grabs him. So it's an aggressive penalty, but, you know, one that the young man will learn from.
So Neil, the quarterback, again, the shotgun, standing at the 33-yard line. Man in motion from left to right. Back to pass, throws a screen, perfectly set up screen, and the Noles are going to react quickly to it and keep it from being any more than a 2-yard gain.
Yeah, they had a little, we did not recognize
Zach
it.
Again,
yeah, that was Zach. He shed his blocker and got the first wrap up and held him to his buddy got there to bring him down. That was an excellent play by Zach Hughes.
There he is, it's under some pressure in there. Yep, that's who it is. Zach was able to shield off a block attempt and be able to bring him down. Second down and 7. Neil on the shotgun, back, steps up in the pocket, and he's going to get wrapped up and thrown down for about a 6-yard loss back to the 32-yard line. Knowles are just teeing off on him.
Yeah, we're mixing it up on the line and bringing some people from different areas. And like I said, our number 7, wherever he is on the field, if you're the offense, you need to know where he's at because he's going to come.
Juan Williams. That was for a loss of 6. 2:40 on the clock. Clock still ticking. Knowles up 14-7. Ball on the 36-yard line. Third down, 13, O'Neal in the shotgun. Knowles threatened blitz. They're bringing it. And out into the flat is a receiver, and there's almost a block from in the back. Number 6 on the catch is Corey Van Borstel. That's going to bring it to fourth down. Yeah, he's going to throw it out in the flat and get it, but... There you go. It's a pretty good tackle there by the Noles.
Good old senior linebacker Zach Hughes sheds his blocker, knocks him to the ground, and wraps the Bayshore Bruin up for the loss.
So that's going to bring up a fourth down and 13. And the Noles are going to see if they can put some pressure. They're loading up over here on the left side, and DQ up the middle. It's going to bounce and get past Tyler Stevenson, who's going to get away from it back at the 15-yard line. The Noles will take over first and 10. Hey, for the third year in a row, Mott & Associates Financial Planners, our industry partners of SETV. Mike Mott, founder and owner of Mott & Associates, is a graduate of Southeast High School and a proud Seminole. For nearly 30 years, the Bradenton-based Mott & Associates has been dedicated to providing the most comprehensive and personal process-driven financial services available. We'd like to extend our thanks to Mike Mott and his team for helping support television students of Southeast High. If you'd like to find out more about the financial services of Mott & Associates, simply go to the website at mottassociates.com. That's mottassociates.com. And there's Peavy up in the middle, who's going to break a tackle and get back across the original line of scrimmage out across the 20-yard line. And he picked up 6 yards that weren't there.
Hey, he carried 3 or 4 people on his back. That's all Mr. 34, Mr. 34, Mr. 34. That is a great power run by him.
Doesn't want to go down.
3, 4, 5 guys. Look at, they're all over him. Just refuses to quit.
Well, we learned last week you don't quit because Palmetto scored by not quitting. Taylor back to pass, going down the sidelines, got an open receiver, got him down in the 45-yard line, inside the 30 to the 23-yard line on the catch. It's going to be Tarrant Pryor, I believe. My gracious, on the money.
That's almost a complete exact replay of the earlier one.
Pick up the number, the jersey number. I'm pretty sure it's Pryor on that side, and it is.
It's Pryor, right out of the slot. Beautiful lofted ball. And then quick to the line of scrimmage again.
There's a quick throw to Tyler Stevenson. Man's blocked out there inside the 20 now. Down to the 18-yard line. They're going to give him forward progress inside the 20 at the 19. So that'll be a pickup of about four and bring up a second down and six.
Yeah, I hear the coach is going crazy next to us. Our man there, his buddy out there on the outside, didn't hold his block. If he did, if he held it for another count or two, we're easily in the end zone.
Second down and six. Ball inside the 20 at the 19. Taylor turns and hands it off to Peavy, who's going to move the pile inside the 16-yard line. Almost at the 15, it's going to bring up a third down. Hey, Dr. Rick Yeur and his family are once again industry partners of SETV. This is the eighth consecutive year that Intercoastal Cardiology has supported the television production students of Southeast High. And through their undying dedication, the Yeurs as well as Intercoastal Cardiology has created many outstanding opportunities for Southeast students. We'd like to extend our utmost gratitude and thanks to Dr. Yeur and the medical professionals of Intercoastal Cardiology of Sarasota for their continued support. Hey, and we're also pleased to announce that the Boys and Girls Club of Manatee County is providing an array of services at Southeast High this year. Among the many programs are Music Makers, where students are taught how to produce their own musical product, a digital arts program where students are taught to use technology and photography to produce various presentations, and Power Hour. This program provides after-school academic assistance, one-on-one tutoring for any student needing help. These wonderful programs take place after school at Southeast, free of charge, and transportation is even provided. If you have questions, you should contact George Schreier at Southeast at Extension 2024 or Travis Cochran at Extension 2224. Let me squeeze in one more. How about our Facebook promo? If you haven't done so, you should like the SETV Facebook page. You can find it on facebook.com/SEHS Television. Not only will you get reminders and direct links to all the events that Southeast Television broadcasts live, but you also get notices of other activities that the fine young broadcasters of SETV are involved in. And while you're at it, share the Facebook link with your friends and family. That's facebook.com/SEHS Television. And it's those kids that are giving us these instant replays and these camera shots.
And those kids work.
They're good.
Yep, those kids work real hard, and they do a great job.
Knowles looking at the third down and three inside the 20. And Alex on the option is going to kick it out. And it looks like Peavy's going to be inside the 10, inside the goal line. Touchdown, Knowles. Got a flag down. And it's going to be against the Knowles, so this one's coming back. Whose idea was that?
Well, and that's disappointing, too, because that flag came from the offside. It had nothing to do with the onside of the play. So if we committed that penalty on the offside when we're running away, that's very disappointing because we got a tremendous block on the onside by our receiver there that opened up that running lane for him to take it to the end zone.
This one's coming back.
Now we're basically third and long. We're not, you know, 12, 13 yards to get a first down. We're not in field goal position.
Well, they've got the ball on the 25-yard line. So we're looking at a third and 12, I believe. Taylor, back, looking to throw. He's got a receiver inside the 25. Huge block inside the 20, down to 10. And it's going to be number 12, our receiver inside. That's going to be Brady Trasalis. He is down in at the 3-yard line. I kept waiting to see if the flag was going to come in. Here we go. There's the pitch. And there he comes in. There's a block right there. Oh, that was that's the one that was called back.
That's the one that was called back. The block in there was Tyler Stevenson.
So we got a work stoppage here as well, so I'm not quite sure what's going on.
Here we go.
It's against the Knowles, illegal procedure. So instead of being first and goal, it's not. I mean, it still is, but it's going to be from about the 9, according to the yard marker.
And this is what really hurts you as a football team, is these mistakes when you get down there in the red zone. You cannot have these penalties that put us back 5 yards.
Taylor in the shotgun's got the snap, fakes it, he throws it out into the flat. He's got a receiver, he's going to be inside the touchdown in the end zone. Didn't want to die, and he's in for the score. I'm trying to see who it is. I think it's going to be Tyler Stevenson, who lines up on the left. Pryor on the right, Tyler on the left. Yeah, there's the throw, and he's way out there. Now watch him. He breaks apart and is able to reach out and get into the end zone for the touchdown to make the score Southeast 20, Bayshore nothing, with 11:21 to go in the first half. Martinez in for the extra point attempt. Hernandez will be the holder, and the ball is going to be up and good. So, 21-0.
21-0.
This is the way you want your season to go.
Yeah, we still need to eliminate the mistakes, but definitely much better execution on a lot of these plays.
Mistakes go down easy when you're up 21.
They go a little bit better. I would really like to see I really like the energy on offense tonight. The quick tempo, I think the guys like that. They're really blocking. They're really laying it all out with some great hits. They've really picked it up nicely on offense.
Mike Sanders sent out a link today to all the staff saying, you know, if you want to watch the game, it's going to be on YouTube tonight. So I clicked on the link and went back to listen to a little bit of last week's game. We didn't have video, we had audio. But while I was there, they had, you know, off to the side of the screen, they had the 1985 game, the entire game of Southeast versus Manatee. And so I started watching it, and what a different team it was back then. We had so much size, so many big guys. Some heavy guys, tall and heavy, that we don't have as many. We were talking about Darian Grant. Darian Grant is a tall man. He's 6'3", 6'4", but, you know, he's not 285 pounds or 300 pounds like some of the big guys we've had, like our kicker Martinez is a pretty big fella, and that's going to hit inside the 30. And Bayshore's going to bring it up the sideline and step out of bounds at the 33-yard line, where they'll take over first and 10. But they had another link on there that was for the perfect season, the 1993 season, when the Noles went undefeated. So I watched that. It's a 10-minute video. You got to go on SETV on YouTube, and that link will probably be there somewhere. But the undefeated year with Peter Warwick and Brett Timmons and Rich Robick and Hines, names from the past that, you know, that are synonymous with Southeast football. But what an amazing, amazing team. Big, big guys, big athletes. And you just wonder, what happened to the big guys? First and 10 for the Bruins. Ball inside the 35-yard line. There's the handoff. And the Noles are going to bring him down at the 39-yard line. It'll be a gain of 4. Pretty good play there, but one of the first positive, other than the long pass, the initial play of the game, is number 32 for the Bruins. Michael Alexander, the senior running back.
Yeah, Zach Hughes missed him there at the line of scrimmage. He's a little disappointed with himself. Jonathan Locke came in and did wrap him up after about a 4-yard gain. Zach had him, though.
Second down and 7, 10:38 to go in the first half. Noles up 21-0. Quarterback now under center. Man in motion. And there's a handoff right up the middle on a dive play. And he gets to the 40-yard line, maybe a pickup of a yard and a half. It's going to bring up a third down and 5 for the Bruins. Bruins decided that shotgun thing may not be doing everything they need.
Yeah, and Chauncey Green's doing a nice job in there tonight. He's our biggest guy at 6 foot and 265. He's sizable.
I think Chauncey's dad was on that 1985 team. There's a fly coming in.
Yeah, a right guard for the Bruins just twitched a little bit, so that's going to cost them 5 yards and put them in a much less manageable down and distance here for their third down.
The other thing I thought was interesting watching the game today, during my lunchtime, by the way. During my lunchtime, I was not supposed to be teaching, I was eating lunch. But I was surprised at the number of people like Farron Horns Sr., who played at Manatee back in 85, and Farron Horns Jr., who came to Southeast and had a stellar career here at Southeast. And there were several other guys. As quarterback back to pass is O'Neill, and he's going to be out to the 42-yard line, and he takes a licking and keeps on ticking. Not enough for the first down, but, man, that was a good hit.
Well,
61 on the hit?
Yeah.
Let's see if we can get the license plate number of that truck that hits him out of bounds.
Now, there's a block in the back that got missed.
There we go. It looks like maybe 20, one of the DBs. See, there's a shot of Grant right there, number 66. He's going both ways. Fourth down and 3. Bruins down 21 with 9 minutes to go. They're going to take a chance here. Back to pass. Knowles coming in. There's a bad pass. It's going to be incomplete. That wouldn't have been enough for the first down anyway. Looking to see who's on the coverage. I think 44 may have been Zach Hughes again right on the receiver. Knowles will take over. First and 10 at the 42-yard line. Great field position. And we've got 8:56 to go in the first half. Knowles up 21 to nothing.
Yeah, it'd be interesting to see if we keep that up tempo here and see what we can do on offense. Maybe get another score before halftime.
Again, we want to thank Popey's Place Restaurant over on West Bradenton, 6409 Mantee Avenue West, 941-761-7674 for the food in the press box. We had some pasta, we had meatballs, we had sausage, we had salad, Greek salad. My goodness, we had a lot of everything and some bread. There's the pitch to Juan Birch, who's going to make a nice cut and get inside the 40-yard line. It's going to be a pickup of maybe one or two, but shouldn't have been any.
No, it was closed off out there, and he just skidded right up the middle there for a few yards. Got the most he could out of it.
Second down and 8 for the Noles. Taylor in the shotgun, standing back on the 45-yard line, rolls right, he's got a blocker, he tucks it up, and he's going to dive forward and get inside the 40-yard line to the just not quite the 39. That's going to bring up a third down and 8. Good tackle there by number 60, number 30, Jarrett Troop, senior defensive end on the tackle. There he is. Good play there by the Bruins. It's a lot easier to see their numbers when you're looking at the instant replay and you got that nice zoomed-in camera. Up here, it's awfully hard to pick up that yellow, and it has been for years, that yellow numbering on a white background.
Well, or even our gray tops with the...
Right. Taylor back in the shotgun looking. He's got an open receiver who's going to break across and fumble the ball. And the Bruins are going to catch it in the air at the 27-yard line. And they'll take over first and 10. I don't know if we have a replay of that. But the receiver doing his best, number 11 for the Noles, to Tavius Galloway. And he's stretching it out. And he gets hit from behind. The ball pops out right into the hands of the Bruin defensive back. And that'll give them first down with the ball, and Galloway is down with an injury.
Well, I hope the young man just had the wind knocked out of him. That's unfortunate there. You know, he's got to feel that pressure from behind and know that tackler's coming up so that he gets two hands on the ball.
Now, we were talking before the game started, Mike, next week we are off. And the following week is a game against DeSoto, and I don't think we're going to travel. I don't think SETV is going to travel down for that game. So if you're looking to follow the Noles,
road trip. Road trip.
All you have to do is get on Highway 70 and head east to Arcadia. Go through town and get just past McDonald's and take a left.
Looks like Jatorius is okay. He might have just picked up a helmet in that lower back area that's uncovered. So hopefully he'll shake it off and be back in here in a few minutes.
JK's got to doctor him up. Coach Carl, trainer extraordinaire. First down for the Bruins. Now the Neil, the quarterback, is going to go back in the shotgun. They didn't have much luck with that earlier. They're going to try it again. Heavy rush. Got a screen set up. And the Noles do a great job of reading the screen and busting through and bringing him down. Trying to look, see who the number was.
Yeah, it's our backers there that are covering because our linemen are not slowing down and reading that screen. So our linebackers are doing a nice job of fighting through the traffic and making a tackle.
Picked up a yard on the play. It'd be a second down and 9. 7:03 on the clock, and it's ticking in the first half. Noles up 21-0. Rare territory for us. We have not experienced that much this year. There's a complete pass out to the 35-yard line, driven out of bounds, short of the first down. And that'll bring up a third down and short for the Bruins. It's going to be third and 2. Got to get to the 37 for a first down. Good crowd for Bayshore traveled over here.
Yeah, it's a nice night for football. The rain didn't roll in. May have cooled off a degree or two.
Pokey's pasta in the press box. And quarterback wrapped up, thrown back for a loss. He tosses the ball, I guess. Did he toss the ball?
I think
he tossed it or he fumbled it before he was going to go down, but the Noles wrap up the tailback and bring him down too.
I think John Locke on the tackle popped it out, and his running back was Johnny on the spot, caught it. But our number 7, Mr. Football, Dequan Williams, was right there to wrap him up.
Yeah, let's see if we can figure out what's going on here. There's the quarterback. See, he does pitch it. He pitches it out, and DQ gets a handful of that jersey and does not let go. Coach Paterno on the sideline there, the offensive coach, likes what he's seen of the defense because it's going to get the ball back for him. Fourth down and 14. Bruins will be back to punt. 5:55 on the clock, and it's still ticking. Noles have already had one block punt. They're going to let this one go. It's going to be a bad kick. It's going to hit at the 38-yard line and bounce backwards to the 35, and they're going to mark it out at the 37-yard line. The Noles will take over first and 10.
Now, there is a yellow handkerchief down, I believe, somewhere on the field.
Water timeout. I know that's what that one means.
Okay.
We saw a flag, too.
Yep, back on the 50.
They never got down there. What would there be a flag down there for? We'll find out. 5:44 to go in the first half. Noles up 21-0. Good crowd. Lots of kids, lots of little kids getting a chance to see, like you said, a good night for football. Nice rain kind of cooled things off to the east of here.
Well, I wouldn't say it's exactly cool, but it's nice.
Well, it was 91 this afternoon, and it's not 91 now, so
no.
That's cooling us off.
Right.
I do want to notice one thing today. I was watching the Manatee Southeast game from 85. They made the comment that people on the sidelines or, you know, around the fence were standing 50 deep, and it looked like they were. It sounds like hyperbole, but it may have been accurate. It was a huge crowd, and it's good to have a little bit of a crowd here. And Taylor's going to get brought down. He was trying to decide if he was going to pull the trigger and go ahead and throw it. He's going to be probably a 7-yard loss back to the 42-yard line.
Well, I'm trying not to be too critical. Alex felt the pressure there. He's got to get rid of that football. There's your pressure. You know, he sees him coming. You know, you're taking a 7-yard loss there when all you have to do is unload that ball out of bounds.
Throw it to your mother. Coach Foster, old buddy, used to say, throw it to your mother on the sideline. Up in the stands. Second down and 16. Peavy, the tailback, flanked to the right of Taylor, the junior quarterback in the shotgun. He's back, fakes a handoff, looking, throws across the middle, and he hits Stevenson, who's going to hang on to the ball at the 50-yard line. So that's going to take up the yards that were lost, plus a couple, and bring up a third down and 8 for the Noles. Got to get to the 42 to pick up a first down.
Well, that was
he
a
took
nice,
a hit.
Yeah, that was a nice pitch and catch, and then he took a good hit from the Bayshore's free safety there. So that was a nice play. Let him nice in front. Good pitch and catch.
Ball on the 50. There's the fake handoff. Throws it over to Tyler. He's got a hole, and he's going to make a man miss inside the 40. 35-30, driven out of bounds at the 30-yard line. First down, Noles.
Well, that little screen there, that little hitch screen to our number 3 was made because of the block on the outside. Our receiver, watch this block if we can see it here. Right there.
Right there, yep. 2 blocks.
Just a great effort on the block there to hold him up in place and let our man advance down the field.
First down for the Noles, handoff to Peavy up the middle. They haven't been throwing the ball. They've had so much success. He'll be inside the 25, about the 24-yard line. That'll be a gain of 6, and bring up a second down and 4. Peavy had 90-something yards last week, I believe 94. They've had so much success throwing the ball. They keep tossing it.
Well, that's been the theme tonight.
Back to pass, throws it in the end zone. He's got him! Touchdown, Noles. And I think it's number 11 again for the Noles is Davis Galloway, who got hurt earlier. You know, put 6 points on the board. That's going to make you feel better. That's a good salve.
Nice to see the young man shake off that little bit.
It's good. I didn't watch it close enough to see it was DQ on the catch. I wasn't watching to see, was it a setup as a fake or?
No, it was a low snap, and we had a fire drill there, and it looks like our number 14 spun out of there, converted it, and
we got backup quarterback advantage.
Yeah, and he made an excellent throw to the corner of the end zone. I tell you, the coaches are just going to love the execution on that play right there.
Yeah, it's a low snap. You can see that. And then Hernandez rolls right, looking, tosses it up, and leaves. Jaquan Williams perfectly in the end zone for the touch, the 2-point conversion. And that's great. You got to love it when you're up 29-0.
Well, that's a play that they practice, that fire drill there. And, it's a hard one for the young men to understand sometimes, but the coaches are just telling you they're going to be busted on the execution of it.
They got a sale on nachos. Kids are walking by the window. Every one of them got a big old plate of nachos. We don't have nachos. We have pasta, sauce, salad. Popey's place. West Manatee Avenue. 641-761-7670. If you don't like what they have brought us, I'm not a pistol. Ball taken at the 18-yard line. Bayshore's got an opening up the middle. Is going to get plugged at the 30-yard line. And that's Nancy, who's coming off the bottom of that pile, is going to be number 10 for the Noles. Demetrius Bryant on the tackle, probably a couple of more with him.
Guys are playing the fired ball tonight. Yeah, we hustled right down the field on that kick and nice tackle. Very aggressive.
3:28 to go in the first half. Noles up 29 to nothing. Senior quarterback with the first and 10, standing 39 yard line under center. Long snap count. And holds off and checks the sideline to see. There's a handoff on a dive play up the middle, maybe a yard. That'll bring up the second down and 9. Clock continues to tick under 3:15. Glad to have Anthony Pusateri in the house. He's an alumnus. When'd you graduate, Anthony? 2006. Keeps coming back here. Trying to get his final credits so he can graduate.
Well,
he's already graduated.
Nice young Italian.
He comes back and gives back to the school that gave so much to him. That's what he's doing. Second down and 9. O'Neill's got an open receiver. Makes the gain out across the 40. Going to be enough for a first down. Good play there by the receiver. Number 20-something.
Yeah, just a little.
Yeah, O'Neill's got the ball. He throws a quick hitter. And I think it's 23. He's going to get across for the first down.
Yeah, Miguel Rodriguez for them. Zach Hughes for us is a little disappointed in himself right there. That man got underneath him a little bit, dug his cleats in, and spun right around.
First and 10, ball on the 44-yard line. Shotgun in motion. Right to left, high snap. Set up a screen, gonna be across the 50 to the Dave Marshall 51 yard line, short of a first down. Under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Yeah, a lot of those screen plays tonight. They've had some success, a little more success on that one. Some of the others trying to make something positive happen before the half so they can go in and have something to build on coming out of halftime. Quarterback back to pass, rolls to his left under a rush. He throws open receiver in and out of the hands of number 30, covered there by number 16, Shannon, at the 30 yard line. Would have been enough for a first down by a lot, but he couldn't catch up with the ball. It'll be incomplete, and that'll bring up a
fourth down. When the pocket breaks down like that and they're scrambling, it's hard to follow your man around the field real tight. And that was an excellent ball the quarterback for Bayshore threw, and his man should have caught that.
Because he touched it. If you can touch it, you can catch it. They're still showing third down, so Bayshore, O'Neill looking to throw. Got a man in his face, could be intercepted. It is at the 45-yard line. Across the 50 and down to the 47. The Noles will take over. First and 10 on the interception is number 8, I believe, for the Noles. Who is 8? Quay Harvey. Everybody celebrating with Quay. You got Quay's picture right here. I saw it earlier. Right there he is. Quay came over the stage today during school and got a tie. The guys wear ties. Which is, I think, is a nice thing. You guys wear ties when you were on game day?
We did. We did wear ties. We actually got to wear ties on Thursday. We got to wear our jerseys on Friday.
So. No?
2 days.
Minute 15 to go, and Alex is trying to communicate with Coach Rashad West. He's on the sideline at the 30-yard line. Taylor in the shotgun, looking at a first and 10. They're going to want to score again. They get the ball coming down the half, and it goes down the sideline. He's got a receiver. Got him! Man, oh, man, it looked like it was on the money to Tresailles. Number 12, Bradley, really stretched out. I thought he had it.
He did. It hit his hands, and it goes right through the bread basket, right there in the middle.
Look how he dove out. He brought the ball in, and it just didn't stay in. He hit the ground.
It slid right down his stomach.
He knocked the breath out of him, too.
Alex got some good protection.
All excited about the 108 to go in the game. Second down and 10. Alex back to pass. Throws it. He's got a receiver. It's higher, Hody! Empire was able to concentrate and bring that ball in. Great defensive play right there.
Number 54 back. Alex Taylor.
Heads are going to roll.
You know, A gap, B gap, and just, I don't know if our guys just thought they were going to stand there and not rush, but they came right down the middle of the line.
I wish we had a camera on Coach Bradshaw, athletic director. He's out here glad handing people in the stands. He's a pretty happy guy for us to be up a score like this, tasting victory and looking around and seeing. Crowds in the stands. That's always a good thing. There's the kick. Come down inside the 15-yard line. The Bruins have it. It's going to go all the way across. They're going to stretch this out. Nice! For the Knolls is, Damian Washington, maybe. Man, I hope we got a replay of that so we can get at least the right name and number. What a play.
Look at this guy here. Flyed down.
Hold it. 28. Watch him, he stretches out, goes from left to right, and we didn't get it, but it was a huge hit. Very nice tackle.
Jonathan Mott was seeing a lot back on the stretch, stretching. Gallatin came up. Nice hit right.
First and 10 for the Bruins inside the 20-yard line. Quarterback again is O'Neill. He is a junior quarterback, 6'2", 200 pounds. In the throws to Kentucky, go up the middle. He's got a lot of room to run. He's going to get to the sideline. Should have enough for the first down out across the 30-yard line. That's a good positive play. That wasn't lightning, was it? Just flashed.
Yeah, that was lightning. And, you know, that run there is to be expected. Play off, play loose, make sure nobody gets behind us. We're going to rush, middle of the field's open, so if we miss them on the defensive line, he's going to turn and run up the field. But no harm, no foul there, 40 seconds left, so.
ball's on the 27-yard line. It'll be a first down for the Bruins, 41.5 seconds to go. Unless you're looking at the SETV, it says 44, but I'm not going to point that out.
With
the director of TV standing over my shoulder. And Neal's looking to break open. He's got an open receiver across the court. Big hit there by number 20. Don't stand over him, son. Just knock him out of bounds and go back to position. Damian Washington, the cornerback, drove him out of bounds on the 49-yard line. Big first down for the Bruins. And somehow or another got out of all that. Got him to the sideline. Here comes Washington. Big hit. Knocked him right out of bounds. That's what you want. Just knock him out of bounds and go back to your position. You got a timeout by the Bruins. 29 seconds to go. They are right on the 50-yard line, Mike. Think they can make something happen? Go in on a positive note.
That's a lot of real estate for him to cover here in 29 seconds. We're playing them a little loose here. They're scrambling. They got out of the pocket there. And we took a little bit of a bad angle there coming up to make that initial tackle. So I think we'll be okay here in the last 29 seconds.
Had a lot of fans call in tonight wanting to know if the Mike and Mike show is going to be on at halftime.
There it is. What'd you tell them?
I told her there's nothing we could do to stop it. So Mike and Mike, Brooks and Sander will be on at halftime. Paul Beckman. Real one or this one?
No, the real one.
The real one. You listen to that, don't you?
Listen to the real one.
They got Bradshaw all the way down on the field. They're trying to get him to come up here in the press box. That's not happening anytime soon. I don't want to be rude or anything, but that's just not going to happen. First and 10 for the Bruins, right on the 50-yard line. O'Neal, the quarterback, in the shotgun. Long snap count, looking, throws it out into the flat across the 45, the 50, down to the 45, down to the 43-yard line. Needs to get to the 40 for a first down. Clock will continue to run until Bayshore, I believe, is going to call a timeout. Our official is emphatic. It's very demonstrative. Second down, looks like, in three. Seventeen and a half seconds to go. O'Neal, the quarterback. We've done our work here. We got Coach Bradshaw on his way up. O'Neal, the shotgun, should have been offside. Somebody jumped. He's throwing. He's going to air this one out. Could be intercepted off the hands of Trusalis, who had great position. Fort. Could have brought that in, but incomplete. That'll bring up a third down, I believe. There's Cody Montgomery, defensive coordinator, on the sideline. He's got to be happy with what he's seen.
Yeah, that ball drifted a little bit more than Bradley thought it was going to, and he didn't quite get under it to make the interception here.
I might have to apologize to Coach Bradshaw because he's already made it up here to the press box. Somebody told him their sausage is still left over, I think. They lied. They're gone.
sausage or meatballs, Mr. Bradshaw.
Third down and three for the Bruins. Quarterback back. He's going to get hit and brought down at the 45-yard line. Clock will continue to tick. That's going to be the end of the first half. Great performance by the Noles on offense and defense. They find themselves 35-0 over the Bruins at halftime. And we are going to be handing it off in a couple minutes here to the Mike and Mike show. That's the end of the first half. The score is Southeast 35, Bayshore nothing. We're going to go take a short break. We'll be back with our very own version of Mike and Mike. You'll be watching the Seminole football on SETV Sports. We'll be right back.
What is it this time? I mean, it's in the trash can. Do you see it anywhere else? Seriously, come on.
Attention, ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? It seems to me there has been an epidemic, and it's time for it to cease. You see, too many young folks are dying from a disease. They think they're invincible until they take her by the hand and find out the hard way that this is not a game. Her name is Mary Jane, and in time, she affects your brain. She affects your memory, your judgment, and your perception. False hope, false peace, this high is only temporary. Can't you see? Or what about Miss Alcohol? About 5,000 teens die every year from underage drinking. Or what about Mr. PD, prescription drugs? About 2,000 teens abuse them every day. These drugs are alive, and they will control you. Addiction crawls in, and they will make you their puppet. And if you think what I'm saying is a gimmick, you might end up in this place. I think I just rested my case.
Thank you. just happens.
Oh, we're on. Should we start all over now that we're on?
I guess we should start over.
Okay. We've been told to start over because something happened. I am Mike. And we are not back better than ever. That's the third time I've done that.
You know what that is? And you know what? That's okay.
Wait a minute. Okay, Mike Sanders, Director of Television, Southeast High School.
Mike Brooks, other things.
Does a lot of stuff around Southeast High School. We haven't figured out what. But Mr. Funderburk, right at the end of the half, he and Mr. Federico were disrespecting us.
Disrespecting us for what?
Because they didn't call us the real Mike and Mike.
We're not the real Mike and Mike.
Oh, but we are you Mike?
I am Mike.
And
you are
Mike,
but we are not the real Mike and Mike. We can't be that.
So we're the fantasy Mike and Mike?
I think so.
Should somebody have chosen us for their fantasy Mike and Mike team?
Yes, because we can't be the real Mike and Mike team.
All right. Well, first of all, I'm just going to ignore it. That we're done with that bit. Let's move on. No. Okay. Now, wait a minute. 400 of you watched listened to the Palmetto game because last week we had camera difficulties. So Randy and Mike did your basic Dark Ages radio show, and we had over 400 hits of you guys sticking with us and listening. But at the very beginning, if you listen to the archive, you will hear this sound.
What was the sound?
You were singing.
I don't want to do that again if it was lousy.
Well, you told me that you wanted to do it again.
No, I just said I wanted to bring that up because you thought it was so funny.
Oh, it was pathetic. It was ridiculous. So, if
that's
any
funny.
Of
my
you
kids
were listening,
tell me I sing good.
Back,
do
know?
I sing good? See, I have a kid right here. Now she's saying
yeah,
no.
I know,
she's,
but
she's saying
yeah, no. I know, but you can fail her and keep her from graduating. What
I would never do
to
such
say?
A thing.
Okay, 35-0.
You know, this is incredible.
35-0.
This is our first district game.
It is important.
And, you know, the kids have shown up to the game today. And I'm having fun. Well, I was. I'm having fun now.
Yeah, I mean, that was a heck of a setup we went through. And we apologize that we went on the air almost 10 minutes late, but we were still chasing technical issues.
And the other thing I apologize for is that I don't have a computer here with able to see what the chat is. Because I'd really like to reply to people who are listening to us like I did last week. That was kind of fun.
You think Mr. Pensacola is still there?
He probably is. He's in school up there.
Hi, Mr. Pence. What was his name?
I can't remember. I believe he was a tech sergeant or something. He was Air Force. I can't give a rating. I don't know. But I know he's in the Air Force. I know he's up at Picola.
And I
know he is looking at studying Herky Birds. And so, you know, I wish we could give a shout-out to everybody that's listening that would send in something on the chat side of YouTube. Unfortunately, I don't have a computer with me right now. I will promise to bring one up next week.
Better.
It's been a busy day.
Yeah, it has been. You have been doing four things at one time for about 6 hours now, haven't
Something
you?
Like that, yeah. And I even had to teach some, too.
Oh, no. No. We don't do... Oh, yes, we do. We do it brilliantly,
yes, we
Dr.
Do.
Green.
No, that's
Dr.
right.
Dr. Green and
Dr.
school
Green,
board
we
members.
Are exceptional
we are
at teaching.
We are great teachers, especially. Holy schmoly. Did you see that lightning?
Yeah, but I think it was a long ways away.
It was. We're about to check the lightning.
I think that was a long ways away, but I will look.
So I really want to take just a second to compliment the SETV students. Okay, that says, excited to listen to you on Mike and Mike. Who was that?
Look.
Hi, Alexis. How you doing? We got texted by last year's president. Executive producer of SETV, who is now up in Tallahassee at Florida State University.
And you know what? She's probably not listening to us.
Well, then why would she text us saying that she liked? She's
well,
listening.
She could have sent that any time prior to the time.
Can't you tell when it was sent?
Oh, you know, I can't tell when it was sent. 8:13 p.m. Oh, see, look at that. That's like half an hour ago.
Oh, jeez.
Okay, so
Alexis,
she's not listening.
You aren't even listening. So anyway, we are.
I think Alexis is listening.
Oh, now she's listening. Now we just got texted.
Okay, so we
listening.
Know we have one. We have at least one listener out there.
We have one.
That's better than last week.
Well,
no,
we
no. Week.
And you know why we're down two listeners? Because Mr. Buckley and his wife is here.
Oh, well,
and he's usually the one. Now I wonder if Bill Verhoeve's out there listening. He usually listens.
Yeah, he does. So a shout-out to Mr. Behovey.
But I know Mrs. Reese is listening because she texted me and said that YouTube looks so much better than that company that we were
you
with
You know,
last
I am
year.
So happy we have done YouTube, and I hopefully our fans are that way too. I'm sorry last week that we didn't get video out, you know, those unexplained failures. They happened at the last minute, and this time I didn't have a spare. I will have a spare next time. Let's see here.
Tire?
Let's see here. We got an image. Look at this.
Oh.
Even a picture. You know what? They would have had a picture of us if they would have brought up the
You know why they sent the picture in the text? Because they wanted us to talk about them and say what nice people they are.
You know what we should do? We should ask them to turn on camera 8.
Yeah. Can you hear us?
Because we
put on the GoPro.
We have
put on the GoPro.
Faces for radio.
See if we can get the GoPro. There it is.
Look at this.
Oh, boy. Okay. I tell you. Show the picture. Show the picture.
Here's the picture right here.
Okay, get it close. Get it close. Get it close. There is Florida State University. Is that exciting or what?
Okay, so anyway.
Okay, get it off of us. Get it off of us.
I would give you all my texts so that we could do that, but you know what? I'm not going to do that because my phone would probably explode, and I only have like 14% power left here, and so I couldn't call my wife when we're done if I did that.
What do you want to call her?
Well, I'd call her lots of things.
Wife and honey and
well, that you know, a happy wife is a happy life.
Yes, it is. I wanted now, 3 minutes ago, I wanted to say congratulations to the SETV students. We really chased some technical issues. Jami Regalado, who is our executive producer and who is the president of the organization, along with all the other students, they have not missed a beat since last year. I am so proud of the broadcast that they're bringing to you and what you have to understand. High school kids, teenagers, but we don't do high school television. We want to bring you as much real life, looking like it's television broadcasting as possible. And I'm extremely, I didn't mean to get, that wasn't a compliment. We just got to thank you from the production table, and I was just schmoozing.
Well, you know,
I didn't mean a thing.
I thought it was so cool that Alexis is watching being the president last year, and then saying, please give a shout out to Jami because Jami is doing great.
Did she really?
She did do that.
She did?
Yes.
Did you hear that, Jami? Alexis said, okay, Jami said that she hoyed that.
And they're even FaceTiming now. So, anyway.
Okay.
But
people in Ohio are watching us. Why is Jami screaming in my ears?
I don't know. We need to turn down that mic a little bit.
Yeah.
Because that is
what's funny
loud.
Is that there's got to be a way to get that microphone into the broadcast because she's actually being funny.
There is a way to get that into the broadcast.
We should do that so that she can talk to us.
Well, have audio bring up the slider on mic number 8, I think it is.
So, yeah. No. Here's what's exciting. First of all, what's exciting is we only have 2 more minutes left, and we haven't gotten even close to rambling on and saying nothing. We can keep talking about nothing.
Nothing.
Okay. Running clock in the second half.
This has happened at Southeast how many times in the last 4 years?
None.
Well, many times, but not with us running the clock.
Not with us running the clock. So we'll be able to, if they keep Bayshore down. Listen, this has been a... That was articulate, wasn't it?
You know, you must have been doing radio your whole life.
I've been doing something my whole life to keep my tongue from working inside of my mouth. And,
you know what? Let's push Poppies.
Poppies plays.
Okay, West Bradenton, 6409.
Poppies.
Poppies. Okay, they have them all over the place. They have them in Palmetto and Port Manatee and Ruskin and Lakewood Ridge, Sarah Bay. But, you know, they did the meal today here in the press box, and I will say that it was pretty sweet.
It was tasty.
It was tasty.
It was tasty, especially the sausages.
So a big shout-out to Popeyes.
Big shout-out to Popeyes.
And so, anyway, you were talking. We have now, 1.5 minutes to talk?
Do you think that the real talents are going to show up on time?
Oh, I think the real talents are right here, but I think the other guys will show up.
Yeah, I agree with you. But last week, we had to open the door, and they were just outside leaning against the fence.
Well, that's because they were enjoying the fact that we were taking the show for them.
Good, because I'm going to have brain damage this evening. My brain is bruised somehow. Shut up, Alexis. I know what you just said.
Well, actually, she didn't text it, but I know what
she said.
No,
I know
too.
Exactly what she just said.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
Because she abused me at the end of her high school career.
You know what? I have so much respect for the way that Alexis was able to abuse
306.
Even Mr. Hawley.
Where's Funderburg? We can't keep doing this.
This one's
Oh. Okay.
I can. We're not doing it yet. I can call a play.
Johnny, look around. Find the talents. Get their butts in here if they are.
Careful there.
Posteriors.
But we could do this.
Go open that door and see if they're standing.
We could do this.
There's Funderburg.
We found one of them. Wow.
All right, that means our time is. We're going to cue you on the video very soon. I hope you're ready to dissolve into the Intercoastal Cardiology halftime show.
Good man.
And here they are. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hope it stays a 35-point lead, and we'll rush this clock off, and we'll get out of here plenty early tonight. But until then, Randy and Mike are coming back to the headphones. Jami, cue that video. Thanks, everybody. Have a great evening.
All right, we're back. It's halftime. The band is performing. Color guard is dancing. Everything looks good. Everybody very festive outside. Did you go out?
Yes, I did. I was out there listening to the band. They sound excellent tonight. Parlaying, I think, a little energy off our 35 points in the first half. So let's see what happens here as we roll into the second half.
A lot to be happy about. 35 to nothing. I don't know what Mike and Mike talked about. 35 to nothing.
I don't know, and I probably don't want to find out.
It'll be bad enough when the letters start coming. People start writing in. Well, the band got off the field pretty fast, so that was, I guess that was quick. Bayshore band came and played. They're kind of small, but they got out and played spiritedly, and then they waited to listen to our band play. So that's good.
That is good. Just got a text message here from my daughter, Alexis Federico, is up at FSU.
Isn't she at FSU now?
At FSU, did the TV production here last year, and she said Sanders gave her a shout-out on the Mike and Mike show. So I'm going to give a shout-out to our new executive producer, and I have a hard time saying her name, but it's Jami.
That's why I'm not saying it.
Right, so I have her first name. I think it's Jami.
I've never seen it in writing.
Regalado.
How do you spell it?
No.
I don't need to know regular. I don't know how to spell Jami.
I
know how to spell Jammy because I put them on every night, but I don't know how to spell Jami.
Right. Took me about 3 weeks of Alexis yelling at me to say, it's Jami, Dad, it's Jami. So Jami's doing a great job for us here tonight. We've got excellent, excellent production. So let's see if we can continue in the second half.
She's a lot more effective when it's not lightning and raining around.
Yes, it is.
So she was at Palmetto last week. And she was going up and down the, you know, up onto the top of the press box, and she was pretty wet and winded by the weather that was there.
Well, she
and you know what she did? I don't know. I'm sure the word didn't get out, but she rescued a $25,000 piece of equipment for Palmetto that the Glad garbage bag blew off of, and it was out in the elements, and she wrote a telegram to the Palmetto people and said you need to come fix your equipment, and they came back later and said you saved our piece of equipment, and that was nice.
Well, that's heads up. That's what we teach them here. That's what Mr. Sanders and Mr. Brooks teach them in the TV program, to be heads up team players, and that's what they're certainly doing tonight.
And that's a nice thing. Hey, we want to thank the folks at Popey's over on West Manatee Avenue. They brought the food to the press box, and we left some of it. I see there's a little bit of it left over there. Pasta and meatballs and sausage and marinara sauce and some salad and some bread, and all is right with the world.
Yep, that food was excellent.
It was great for my low-carb diet that I'm on.
I'm on a low-carb diet too. Eat every single one I can find.
Get the lowdown on the carbs. You know what? A couple years we had Matt Everhart up here, and Matt was keeping us up to date on the stats. We don't have a stat guy. We don't have a super stat guy anymore.
Yeah, we need one. Maybe we can get that for the next home game.
You know, if Jami had any kind of cred, she could get a stat person and
put the stats up on the screen so we could see it, and we could read off like we know what they are.
Right. We could be talking about the halftime production right now as we move into the second half of what they had in the first half. So,
And what was happening now is we're left to make the stats up. Like, we had 337 yards of passing offense in the first half.
Yep. Next home production will have that, though. I'm very confident that Miss Regalato will produce that for us and have it on the screen as we sit here getting ready for the second half in a couple of weeks.
Well, it's what the fans want. The fans should get.
That's what the fans demand. They don't want to listen to us. They want to see that what we produced on the field in the first half.
They could get this kind of stuff from Tiger Vision.
Mm-hmm. They could.
Tiger Vision is what they had last week at Palmetto. At Harley Stadium.
Well, I believe we get the ball here in the second half, so let's see what kind of energy we come out here, and let's see what we do.
I wonder what the requirements are for a running clock.
That's a good
35
question.
35 points, isn't it?
I think we're right there. I think that might be the number. Let's see what happens with that clock after the kickoff and see if it keeps moving.
I thought we had a running clock last week. That was the fastest first half I've ever been through. We were finished with the first half by 10 after 8.
Yeah, there's very little throwing of the ball, which, you know, incompletions interrupt, and they were running it, and it kept that clock moving, and it seemed like the first quarter took all of 10 minutes.
Well, the teams are out here on the field warming up, as you can see. They're stretching and running and... roster off. Bayshore over to Wendell so he'll have something and call their names. That's all Bayshore, man. That's Bayshore. What the world needs is more rosters.
More rosters. Well,
rosters all around. Tyler Stevenson will be back deep for the Noles. Along with Terrence Pryor. Junior? Is he a junior? Is that what his name is? Terrence Pryor Jr., J.R. That means there must be a Terrence Pryor Sr. someplace.
Well, Bayshore's a little slow getting out on the field. The ref's pushing them a little bit. Pick it up.
Don't you love these long, uncomfortable periods of silence?
Yeah.
That's why if we had stats on the screen from Jami, we wouldn't have that.
We could be breaking them down. That would have taken off that little slow period there and just sauntered right into the second half.
See, if you don't keep the fans at home interested, they go to the kitchen to get a sandwich and they don't come back.
Right.
Well, they're going to be a kickoff here, and it's the first kickoff, I think, for Bayshore. Come down to the 13-yard line, across the 20, the 25, 30. He's going to go down the sideline, and he gets caught from behind at the 40-yard line. A good tackle there by number two is Mikael Green. He's a wide receiver, free safety. And if it hadn't have been for Mikael Green, they'd still be running.
Yeah, and I'm surprised that
Pryor's still down.
He's got a cramp, and I'm surprised there that he caught him from behind because it was wide open field, one more man to beat, and he was going to be in the house.
He makes a cut, and there's a nice block there, and that guy just dives out and grabs him.
Just got him from behind. I think we had a blocker tied up with the kicker, so that probably would have been 6 points if we didn't get him.
Well, that's good. They got the cramp worked out. Get some fluids in him. So the Noles will have it first and 10 from the 42-yard line. And the clock's not running, so that must not be the deal. Maybe the coaches have to agree to it. You're going to Google? Are you going to Google running clock?
I'm going to Google that.
We could ask the clock official down here. I bet he knows since it's his finger on the button.
There's a handoff to Peavy. He's going to be across the 45, across the 50, down to the 45. He doesn't want to go down to the 43-yard line. First down, Peavy on the carry.
I tell you, he shot up in the hole there. He makes a great spin move like a pinball, and it just fights when he gets hit. I mean, he just does not go down at all with the first hit.
Well, he's the one that did the pirouette last week, wasn't he, that just kept on going? It's so good. There he is on the handoff up the middle. He's got a seam across the 20, down to the 22-yard line. He's going to be across the 30, down to the 23, they'll mark. And another first down by Latrell Peavy.
Yeah, this is what I expected here in the second half for us to come
They're
out.
They're going to run?
Run the ball, yeah.
How exciting is that?
Well,
Peavy likes it.
Yeah, Peavy likes it. Our guys need to work up front, so let's see what we can do and execute these plays because they're going to start putting more men in the box.
Oh, there's a pass play. He's getting wide open in the end zone, and nice tip there by that DB to get this ball tipped and knock the thing away because Tyler Stevenson had six.
Yeah, that ball hung up there just a little bit, but the DB for Bayshore was able to recover and knock that ball down at the last second.
9:40 and the clock is ticking. Second down and 10, ball on the 23-yard line. We have to close that door. We're going to hear the coaches say things that we're not rated for. Nice snap, handoff to Peavy. Makes one man miss. He'll be inside the 20, down to the 17-yard line. And that's going to bring up a third down.
Hey, still picked up a few yards there up the middle in that little tough run that he had right there. That's not bad.
Coach West stalking the sideline. I think Coach West calls the offensive plays. Former quarterback from the 1996, 97, 97, 98, I guess 96, 97 school year. Would have been his senior year. There's a handoff to Peavy, and he's going to get hit in the backfield outside the 20-yard line. And driven back, and that's going to bring up a fourth down. I think you go for it here. I don't think you trust your kicker from this distance.
Yeah, you'd be at about a 40-yard kick, so I don't think we're going to kick this. That little handoff for the sweep, they got penetration at the tackle, and especially at the defensive end there. Just put a stop to that play, and probably lose 4 or 5 yards. Yeah.
So it's fourth down and 8. The ball's outside the 20-yard line on the 21. They got to get inside the, it looks like, 14. For the first down, Alex Taylor, the junior quarterback, in the shotgun's got the snap. It's high. He's looking across the corner. He's got a receiver. It's going to be out of bounds. Led Tyler Stevens too much. And that'll be incomplete. And the Bruins will take over. First and 10. 21-yard, 23-yard.
So the clock is running now. So both coaches must have agreed to it. It has to be 35 points or more. Has to have both head coaches agree to it, so it is running. That's a running clock.
We might get home at a decent time tonight.
Get home at a decent time tonight, yes. Maybe I'll stay and help the kids put all the equipment away.
How about that Coach Brian McKnight here? Coach, when did you play here? So I was just telling earlier, because we're killing time here, I saw online the 85 Southeast Manatee game was on YouTube today, and I was watching part of it, looking to see if you were playing. Were you? I didn't hear your name called, but I heard Greenhall's name called. Was it? Well, I guess I should be calling this because that was pretty good. That's a pretty good play there. Coach Brian McKnight in the house with little son Jackson. And they came up here to eat some pasta, too, that was left over. And that was a big defensive play there by the Knowles. I didn't even see what happened. How can we get a 14-yard loss? Now I can see. That was a pitch play.
on the sweep, and he gets thrown back for a 14-yard loss. That's huge.
Yeah, it's just a pitch play to the backside, back halfback coming around, and we were all over that.
I thought Coach McKnight was on that 85 team. Said he was a sophomore. But he was a backup center. There's a good pass. Could be intercepted. Oh, in and out of the hands. Number 22, Houston had the opportunity to get it, and man, oh, man, look at Coach Clark. He thought he had one there.
Tariq Houston knocked that ball up and was going with the tip drill, and then his man came in and undercut him a little bit and could not come down with it. Excellent play.
That would have been a nice thing to have.
Excellent play. He got the sack at the end of the first half, and he's picking right up where he left off.
All right, well, we got 5:42 on the clock. Somebody must have called a timeout because it's not running and everybody's on the sideline talking. Looking at a third down and 24 for the first down. Ball at the 9-yard line. Knowles in great position here to stop this and get the ball back. Uncomfortable moment of silence.
Well, they got third and forever here, so I don't know what kind of play. I mean, they don't want to turn the ball over here in their territory right here, so I wouldn't be surprised if they just run this up the middle and get a little more room and try to punt it. Right open out there in the flat. Here the coach is yelling, number two.
And O'Neill's going to look to throw, and he's got a completion, but the Knowles are going to swoop in on that. Brandon Shannon, he's quick, and he wrapped him up quick and brought him down. So that's a good play there by the defensive Knowles.
Yeah, and they're going to kick here. They have to. So fourth and forever on their 11-yard line. They've got to try to punt it out of there rather than turn the ball over on downs.
Tyler Stevens will be back at the 45-yard line awaiting the punt. Kick will be standing in the end zone, so the Knowles get good field position, assuming they can field this. They've already got one blocked.
I don't think they'll go after this here.
Nice snap. Pretty good kick. Going to drive Stevenson back. And he's going to get it at the 50. He's going to come back to the left. He's going to go up the middle, make one man miss across the 40-yard line, out to the outside. He's got some blockers. He's going to be down the sideline, and he's going to get pushed out of bounds outside the 20, outside the 10-yard line. It's all the way across the field from us, so we're trying to see where it is. There's a flag, according to SETV, back at the 40-yard line, 38-yard line. So that's probably coming back.
Yeah, at a corner of my eye, I saw a couple blurs, and when you see those blurs like that, those are usually collisions that are not in the front number. So,
hey, we're proud to announce Kaiser University of Sarasota is once again a business partner of SETV. This is the 12th year Kaiser has supported the television production program of Southeast High. At Kaiser University Sarasota campus, you get the training you need to pursue a new career in the fields of business, criminal justice, education, healthcare, information technology, law, and much more. They offer associate, bachelor's, and graduate degree programs. Their Sarasota campus also offers culinary arts and a baking and pastry program. To find out more about what Kaiser has to offer, simply by going to their website at kaiseruniversity.edu.
Well, that's a big penalty there. That cost us about 40 yards on the return. Backs us all the way up to the 49-yard line. On the onside part of the field, so that hurts.
Hey, we want to thank our tonight's sponsors, Frontier Communications, Howard Leasing, Key Glass, Below Pharmacy, Signs Zoo, Firkins Automotive, and First Manatee Bank. Knowles on a handoff. It's going to get snuffed out pretty quickly. Keon Birch on the tackle. Tackled by Jeffrey Clark.
Yeah, our running game. Yeah, our running game there. I mean, he just busts in off here, off the end here, and this comes right up there and wraps him up 5-6 yards deep in the backfield and throws him down for a loss.
Clock is still kicking. Running clock still ticking. Under 2 minutes to go, almost, in the third quarter. Taylor back to pass. He pumps. He's going down the sideline. He's got Trusselis. He's going to be complete inside the 10, down to the 1 yard line. Another big catch, throwing catch. Trusselis, man, he's got to have 150 yards, doesn't he?
He's got a lot of
big catches.
Yeah, what was really nice about that, that ball was underthrown a little bit and towards the middle of the field. He really adjusted his route to get there, to get underneath that ball and make that great catch.
Number 12, Bradley Trusselis. There's a handoff. Keon Birch, who's going to break a tackle and he's going to get pushed and shoved inside the goal line. Put those hands up. Put those hands up, Stripes. There he is. Touchdown, Knowles. To get in there and say it for sure like he was in, and he is. I want to thank United Hoist Incorporated for the pregame meal and Sonny's Tea. Sonny's Sweet Tea on sale at the concession stand. And again, thank Popey's Place on West Manatee Avenue for the press box hospitality. Hey, Seminoles, Frontier Communications, a proud supporter of Southeast football. If you're a Frontier Fios customer, you don't have to miss out on your favorite shows while you're at the game tonight. Use your Frontier TV app to schedule recordings right from your smartphone. For more information, visit frontierflorida.com. Knowles in for the extra point attempt. Martinez has it up, and it is good.
I tell you, that was some run by Keon Birch there.
Did we have it on replay? Did Jami have a replay of it?
Well, we didn't get a replay of it, but that was all him. I mean, he fought the first tackler off, bounced off another guy right there, and then willed his way into the end zone. Fantastic run by our number five.
Why would Jami let us down like that?
Well, Jami's learning the ropes a little bit, so she's doing a nice job tonight. She's
doing a very nice job. We're just picking on her.
Right.
Because we can.
Picking on her because we can, and we got a little dead time. So.
That's right. If she's not going to give us stats on the screen, we're going to talk about her.
Right. That's right.
Hey, we got double zeros on the clock, so that's going to be the end of the third quarter with our running clock. We might be home by quarter till. Wouldn't that be something?
That'd be great. Get the win and get on out.
They'll have pictures and stats and everything in the newspaper tomorrow, because I think we're the only game in town, aren't we, tonight, pretty much?
Manatee was up in Tampa at Alonzo, I believe.
Oh, Lakewood Ranch and Braden River.
Lakewood Ranch.
So I guess that's a big game for some people.
Assuming that Braden River probably has that game under control.
You have the app on your phone, don't you?
I do not have the app.
What?
I just have to go to good old internet.
You just goggle it?
I just goggle it.
Let's just make up a score.
Yeah, we'll see.
Let's get Jami to put up on the screen a fake score.
Now that would be nice, is this part of the game, to have all the other high school scores rolling along the screen for us and everything.
We got the reporters up here in the booth with us eating our spaghetti and pasta and meatballs. Maybe they could tell us what the scores are of the other games.
Oh, it's a lot closer than I thought. Braden River 10, Lakewood Ranch 0 at the half.
Well, that's good. Somebody's raised their game. All right, the Knowles have it teed up on the 40-yard line. We got to get serious here. Here's the kickoff. Well, that's a pretty good kick. It's going to come down inside the 15-yard line. It's going to be the reverse. There it is, and the Knowles sniff it out. Across the 22-yard line. They'll stop him in the first 10 from the 22. Bayshore getting creative, trying to make something happen. Razzle-dazzle.
Well, they've got nothing to lose. They're going to try whatever they can to get some guys on the field, get some experience, and see if they can't put some points on the board here in the fourth quarter.
11:33. There it is. Now here's the pitch. Watch this. There it is. We were confused. Look at the Knowles sniff that out. There it is. They got him, brought it down. Late substitution there for the Bruins. Quarterback and the shotgun, man in motion. That's jumped off, should have been offsides. And it's complete out to the 25-yard line, across to the 28. I threw a flag on that, but nobody saw it.
Something didn't look right.
Something didn't look right. If it doesn't look right, it's usually not right. It usually should be a flag, but they're going to probably keep the hankies in their pockets here a little bit coming down the stretch.
Second down and three for the Noles. O'Neal, the quarterback, he's back, flag down, looking to throw, and it's time on the field. You know, it should really be nice to Johnny because we haven't had any face shots on the screen from the press box. Yeah. And maybe that's the reason. Look at the crooked GoPro.
Well, maybe we should leave it that way.
There we go. It's got magnets on the bottom. There we go.
There we go. Now there will be no face shots, Johnny.
First and 10. O'Neal throws a complete out across the 33-yard line, out close to the 35 before he's driven back. Could have had a picture of Mr. Schreier there walking through. All right, Johnny, turn it on.
No.
There he is. That way Alex up in, at the Florida State University can see your father blow her a kiss.
No, I don't think so.
I don't have a daughter anymore at Florida State. She's already finished up there. She got her MRS degree, and she lives with her Who's band and three children in Montgomery, Alabama. She used to watch these programs, but then since I don't get FaceTime anymore, she doesn't watch. The kids, grandkids never see me but once a year at Christmas. Second down and 10, O'Neal on the keeper. He pitches it high, and I tell you, the tailback was lucky to bring that down and keep it from being a fumble.
Yeah, O'Neal played a little hot potato there, and at the last minute when he knew he was going to get crushed, he just, threw that ball up for grabs. Number five for them made a nice play bringing it down.
Holds up 42-0. If you just joined us, where you been? It's a pretty good game. Haven't had many good games this year. This is one of them, or the one. Third down and 13 for the Bruins. All on the 29-yard line. O'Neal, the junior quarterback, he's back. He's looking. He's got a man across the middle, and he's got him. And he should have enough for the first down as he gets close to the 45-yard line. He was open.
Just a slant route across the middle. Their number 81 made a nice catch, and O'Neal has got a nice arm. He throws a nice ball when he gets some time back there.
He does. Just hasn't had a whole lot of time.
Nope.
They need something to happen. They need something positive to happen. You know, as they go into next week. Now here he is. He's got the man going across the middle, and he's got him. Let's wrap him up and bring him, but not until he gets first down. Back to throw. He's wrapped up. The ball is loose. And I think the center got it, was able to catch it in the air and get it back to the line of scrimmage. So that's a positive thing for them. Hey, for the third year in a row, Mott & Associates Financial Planners are industry partners of SETV. Mike Mott, founder and owner of Mott & Associates, is a graduate of Southeast High School and a proud Seminole. For nearly 30 years, the Bradenton-based Mott & Associates has been dedicated to proving and providing the most comprehensive and personal process-driven financial services available. We'd like to extend our thanks to Mike Mott and his team for helping support the television students of Southeast. If you'd like to find out more about the financial services of Mott & Associates, simply go to their website at mottassociates.com. That's mottassociates.com. There's your replay, by the way.
There it is.
Right in the middle of my Mott's advertisement.
And it's a close-up replay, too. Zoomed in.
That was good. Who is number 52 for the Noles?
52 is Jordan Sims. Got a little cramping going on, but he's fine. He's going to come out for a play and hopefully go back in, limping a little bit.
He's got a little hitch in his get-along.
Yes, he does. Well, we're playing a lot of young guys on the defensive line right now. We're not blitzing, so.
We got a lot of clean uniforms?
A lot of clean uniforms, but they're getting some good experience. Number 75, Francis.
Cercilius.
Is that how you say it?
Well, let me see it in writing because I had him as a student. Clercius, yes. Francis. There's actually two of them, Francis mm-hmm. and Frank. They're twins.
So Francis is in there now.
Second down and 11. Knowles threatened to blitz. They're going to bring it. And there's the pitch. Around, sweep around the right side. And he's going to pick up a yard or two. Close to the 45-yard line. That'll bring up a third down and 9. And the cheerleaders are throwing T-shirts up into the stands. And everybody gets excited.
What kind of shirts are they?
They're like T-shirts, and this is the reason why you don't want to leave early, because here we are with 6 minutes to go in the game, and the cheerleaders are throwing clothes up into the stands, and the people that went home early are going home empty-handed.
Are they Southeast football shirts?
What I don't know.
Wow, that'd be great.
I don't know, but they're airing them out, and people are fighting for them. They must be good shirts. Third down and 10. Knowles threatened blitz. It's a high snap, and it's going to be sacked back at the 24-yard line. That's a big play. Was that DQ on that?
Yeah, that was a bad snap on their part, and then DQ tripped a little bit, tripped him up.
Let's see if it's DQ's hit. It goes over his head, and DQ's out trying to get to him, and he dives and knocks him down, but O'Neal's able to fall on the ball.
Yeah, if Daquan would have kept his feet there, he might have had a shot at pouncing on that ball.
Now they're throwing footballs into the stands.
Footballs.
The little plastic footballs, yeah. These are the kind that Tommy Jamisco used to steal from the little kids. He wouldn't let them get them. He'd take them himself.
Now, these are orange. These got to be Southeast football. I wonder if our SETV production department could get a hold of a few of these for us.
Would you like to have one?
I'd love to have one for my office.
You could put a little duct tape on the bottom of it and tape it to the dashboard of your car, and it would always go where you go.
Well, and I've got a beautiful office with some nice shelves up there with all my little football knickknacks and stuff. It would go perfect on there.
You know what's going to go on your shelf this year? Hate to spoil it for you, but it could be the little appreciation plaque from SETV.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
And they're nice, too. They don't spare any expense on the appreciation plaque. Look at the balls all the way up here to the back row. One of those cheerleaders got a howitzer.
She's got an arm. Sign her up.
Got a cannon. Hope she doesn't hit this window. We're going to have glass in our beards. All right, here's the punt, and it could be almost blocked. And it's going to drive. Boy, somebody's going to do some running. Oh, my goodness. 28 is going to be Townsend, I think, on the carry. Clyde Townsend. And, he let that ball get by him. Now, watch him when he gets to the ball. He goes beyond him, and he's going to run and pick it up, and almost knee almost goes down. There, see, he's lucky that knee didn't touch.
Well, his motion was a little smooth and steady. Didn't look like he was in a hurry to pick that ball up. And then he did and made a nice jab step and a cut back the other way. So, got a couple of yards out of it.
4:35 on the clock, and it continues to tick. We have a running clock. Knowles are up 42-0. It's a Southeast Seminole, property of the Southeast Seminole shirt. The guy's holding it up. He's proud of it. He's holding it up right down there. He's got a white shirt. It says, property of Southeast Seminoles.
I wonder
hope
how
they don't accuse him for stealing it. Well, Bayshore's going to wrap him up and bring him down there. It's not going to get anything out of that and like it.
Yeah, we got all our young guys in there on the offensive line now getting some experience. So that's
Don't disrespect the young guys.
No, we got our young. It's great for them. Let them get in there and get battle tested and get some work tonight. It's great for them. You know, they're going against these juniors and seniors for Bayshore who've got some pride and still playing hard.
There's a run up the middle. Keep pushing and shoving out near the 29-yard line. Good to see Liz Kirby in there playing.
Yeah, yep, number 70.
Yeah, Liz Kirby, offensive line. She's getting some action.
That's great.
She's in there at right guard. Next to Brodsky, the center.
Number 51. Michael Brodsky's in there.
Yeah, had Brodsky last year in driver's ed. Got Liz this year in driver's ed. Hernandez, the quarterback's going to tuck it up. And he's going to have the first down and more down the middle across the 50, the 45, the 40. And he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. First down, Knowles. There's your backup quarterback ripping off a big 55-yard run.
Yeah, and he had one more to beat and almost had him. That's a nice run for that young man right up the middle there.
He's going to hand it off now.
About a four.
I don't want to run it anymore. I'm done. Now watch Hernandez here. Tristan, he's going to tuck it up, go right up the middle, and he's going to break one tackle, another tackle. There's a third tackle. There's a fourth one. He's finally going to get brought down. And there's the handoff up the middle. And push back across the 25. Just got to put the shoulder down in there and push the guy across or push him back on his big numbers. 2 minutes to go in the contest. This thing's going to be finished by 9:30. All is right with the world. There's the handoff. And he'll be inside the 25 to the 24-yard line. That'll bring up a third down.
Third down. Probably run it again. Number 67 playing right tackle for us. Jesus Palacios.
Got a third down and nine. Quarterback hands off. Now he's got it inside the 20-yard line. It'll be a pickup of about four, and it's going to bring up a fourth and five with a minute 23 on the clock. And again, I think we're outside the comfortable field goal range.
Yep, Johnny, number 15, Johnny Schoolfield running the ball there. Sophomore running back. So some of the guys, young guys, getting some work tonight. It's good to see.
So here we are on fourth down. And Hernandez is going to try to air it out. He's got in the end zone. It's going to be tipped. Incomplete in the end zone. The ball hung up, and the defensive back was able to work his way back over there and break that up. Hey, we want to thank our folks, our sponsors, Frontier Communications, Howard Leasing, Key Glass, Pillow Pharmacy, Sign Zoo, Perkins Automotive, First Manatee Bank. I want to thank United Hoist Incorporated for the pregame meal, Sonny's Iced Tea, which is on sale in the concession stand, and Popey's Place on West Manatee Avenue for the press box hospitality. And if Frontier Communications is a proud supporter of Southeast football, and if you're a Frontier Fios customer, you don't have to miss out on your favorite show while you're at the game tonight. Use your Frontier TV app to schedule recordings right from your smartphones. And Bayshore's got a play in motion. And it's going to pick up 7 yards with no defense against them. They picked up seven.
Hey, the official set the ball. We didn't have our team out there, and he let them snap it. And like a Chinese fire drill, we were out there running on the field at the last minute to try and stop the play.
Well, that's the end of tonight's game with the final score, Southeast 42, Bayshore nothing. We're going to take a short break for a couple of public service announcements. We'll be right back to wrap it up on the Kaiser University postgame show. You're watching Seminole Football on SETV Sports. We'll be right back.
Hey, What's up?
Nothing. Who's this?
I'm John. I went to your school last year. I saw your pictures online, and you're really pretty.
Oh, thanks.
How old are you?
I'm 16. And you?
Cool. I'm 17.
I don't think I ever met you.
Yeah, I was always too shy to talk to you. But my parents are out of town this Friday, and I'm having a party. Wanna come?
Sure. Sounds cool.
Awesome.
I'll see you there.
Back to Paul Meckley Field at John Cochran Memorial Stadium, where we have tasted victory for the first time this week. And because of that, we get to be on air. See, there you are. There you are. That's us. So the kids in Montgomery, my grandkids, will notice that I've lost 40 pounds since May.
Well, my daughter in Tallahassee will probably...
She won't know who I am.
Yeah, she won't know who you are, and she'll just probably thinking to herself, Daddy, just keep the checks coming.
Yeah, just going over the stats that we don't have. Southeast had 643 yards of passing and 29 first downs.
Sounds like a winner to me. Probably another 80-90 on the ground by number 34, Mr. Peavy. So let's call it a night with a 42-0 verdict. We're off next week. And then the following week on the 30th, we travel at DeSoto, I believe, for a big
somebody
district.
Travels.
Somebody
we don't.
Travels.
You traveling? Are you going to go there?
Well, you know, that's probably, I live out in Paris, so that's pretty close to my house. I just got to get on the road and head east. So.
You could go out there and phone in the scores, phone in updates.
I could. I could take some video with it and post it on YouTube.
Jami could show old replays, and you could just call in and give update scores, and everybody would be happy.
And we'd have a production, right?
That's right. And SETV would have a continuous production of week after week of having something on the air.
Every game.
This was a big game for the Noles. They needed to taste victory. It's a division, district game, I guess is the word they use for it, district game. So we are 1-0 in the district, and Bayshore is not. And there's only four teams in the district, I think.
Well, that sets the pace right there. Well, obviously, we have to win all our district games. We did play much better tonight. We, we found a quarterback, got some rhythm on that fast-paced offense. He threw some nice balls, so that was good to see. I think we got to work on our line play a little bit and get more consistent on blocking so that we can have a positive running game without any losses. That's one of the things I think we'll work on. The execution on the kicking game on the extra points was much better, and basically on all of his kickoffs, one or two that he popped up, so that's big right there. So overall, much better play in all facets of the game. I think we've got a real solid defense now moving into the season, the heart of the season. We just got to get a little more consistency on the offensive side of the ball, running the ball. Tonight it was all big plays, which we'll take them. But we're not always going to have that opportunity. So I think moving forward, if we can establish some more running game and consistency on the offensive line blocking, I think we're going to do fine in the district.
Final score, Southeast 42, Bayshore nothing. We are 1-0 in the district. We have two more games to play. I understand that from Coach Montgomery that the cupboard might be bare at DeSoto. So if we can win at DeSoto, that makes us at least the runner-up. If it's a four-team district, we either win it or we're the runner-up. So, I don't know. This might work out to be a season of postseason play. You just never know. Don't want to count your chickens before they're hatched, whatever that means. Final score, 42-0, Southeast over Bayshore. Thanks for tuning in to SETV. Thanks for Jami and all the kids for putting on, doing the great work. And we will be back in a couple of weeks. Bringing all the next action. Until then, this is Randy Funderburt for Mike Federico, Mike Brooks, Mike Sanders, Jami.
Rigatoni?
Regalado.
Regalado? Okay. Anyway, for all the crew here, thanks. We'll see you next time. Good night, everybody.